This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
More often than not, the gay scene is looked upon with either disgust, is totally ignored, or at best is treated as an exotic subculture. But now that Indian society seems to view itself as more sexually bold, at least on the surface, is homosexuality gaining a greater understanding? Is there more acceptance? Mumbai is a good place to start looking for some of these answers. 24 hours in the city where different voices help us unravel the complex, sometimes funny, often difficult and confused experience of being gay in urban India. When we met Kanchan Karani at her music classes, she seemed like an unlikely spokesperson for gay or lesbian rights. She's not an activist in a formal sense, but her willingness to talk candidly on television about her personal experiences of dealing with her son's sexuality makes her a powerful voice, a voice that an increasing number of families across India can identify with.
पहले ऐसे लाइट भजन सीखती थी, अभी क्लासिकल में ही ज्यादा है. और हम लोग हाउस वाइफ है तो वो गैप तो पड़ती है. दिवाली आई, आया कुछ भी आया तो गैप पड़ती है. चलो मैं बिचारे.
The conversation unfolds back in the comfortable familiarity of their middle class home.
I think the thought process evolved, so to speak, because of reading newspaper articles, because of satellite television coming into India, and you're seeing a lot of shows on Donahue or Oprah Winfrey. You watch millions marching on Washington, I think it was 1990 or something. So all that, you know, it gives you courage. It lets you think differently about yourself instead of being in a box.
How did you finally tell your family?
I didn't go up directly and tell her. I used to have a drawer full of newspaper articles and Bombay Dost issues. And I used to keep it locked. So one day when I was sure in my mind that I'm okay with discussing it with her, with telling her, with telling my parents, I kept it unlocked. I knew that my mom was curious about it. She did open the drawer and she came up to me one day and sat down next to me and asked me, what are these magazines on gay doing in your drawer?
हाँ, मुझे कुछ लग रहा था, लेकिन इतना ये सब कुछ मालूम नहीं था इनके बारे में. भाई क्या है, होता है ये, भाई गे का मतलब क्या है, मैगजीन में क्या है. लेकिन कुछ डिफरेंट है ऐसे लगा, समझ में नहीं आया बराबर. फिर मैंने अपने कजिन्स को, इसके कज़िन को फ़ोन किया, भाई ऐसे ऐसे कुछ है, मुझे समझ में नहीं आता, आप आओ. तो उन्होंने फिर समझाने लगे, भाई हाँ ऐसे होता है. इतने में नितिन भी आ गया, फिर बातें होने लगी और मालूम पड़ा. लेकिन शॉक तो हो गए भाई, ये सब क्या है.
क्या आपने पहले क्या रोकने की कोशिश की, समझाने की कोशिश?
हाँ, ऑफ कोर्स, हम लोग तो इनको बोलेंगे मान जाएगा. तो इनको समझाने ही लगे, नहीं नहीं आपको तो शादी करनी है, ऐसे कैसे होगा, सब ठीक हो जाएगा, सब ठीक हो जाएगा. या भाई समझो भगवान का नाम लेते हैं भाई, तो उस पर रखो भाई, चलो ठीक हो जाएगा.
I think they thought of it as a... probably impotency or as a mental illness, and my dad used to say this a lot, that we'll take to the best doctor and we'll treat you.
अभी तो धीरे धीरे फिर सब थोड़ा ये पढ़ने के लिए भी देता था, भाई पढ़ो तो मालूम पड़ेगा आपको भाई क्या है. और इनके फ्रेंड्स आते हैं, उनसे बातें होती है, तो मालूम पड़ा भाई हाँ ये सब नेचुरल है और इसका कुछ नहीं कर सकते. इसके फादर अभी भी रिसेंटली भी ऐसे बोलते थे, भाई नहीं नहीं शादी करो, ऐसे कुछ नहीं होता है ऐसे अभी भी. लेकिन अभी रिसेंटली, बिल्कुल रिसेंटली अभी थोड़ा समझने लगे, भाई हाँ अभी फोर्स करना कुछ फ़ायदा नहीं है.
इस सब के बाद नितिन अभी भी आपसे बात करता है? हाँ. सारी चीज़ें
नहीं, एक्चुअली ये नहीं करता है, या उसको लगता है भाई मेरे को अच्छा नहीं लगेगा या मैं कैसा फील करूँगी, ऐसे मुझे लग रहा है. इसके लिए ये खुली तरह से मेरे से बात नहीं करता है. लेकिन फिर मैं भी सोचती हूँ चलो ठीक है, जैसे उसको अच्छा लगे.
Maybe I'm not comfortable talking about it.
हाँ वही मैं बोल रही हूँ ना, मुझे लगता है ये कंफर्टेबल नहीं फील करता है, तो इसके लिए मैं भी इसको कुछ फोर्स नहीं करती हूँ, यहाँ ऐसे वो बात ही नहीं निकालती हूँ. भाई ठीक है, उसको जब भी मन में आएगा तो बात करेगा.
And sometimes I want to spare her the rubbish I go through.
Like
people I meet, relationships.
Have you ever told her about your relationships?
Not really. I don't discuss my relationships. I think that's what she's referring to.
एक शायद एक वक्त में आपको एक बहू की ख्वाहिश थी, तो अभी लगता है कि कोई होना चाहिए जिसके साथ सेटल हो जाए.
नहीं लगता.
कोई औरत नहीं पर कोई.
हाँ वो भी ऐसे होता है कि ये सेटल होएगा, लेकिन मुझे इतना फील नहीं होता है और इतना मैं खुश नहीं हूँ, खुश नहीं होंगी शायद.
This has been, we've been discussing this for a long time, but the only thing that's come out is somehow she's uncomfortable with the thought of a strange man in this house with me.
Oh. It is different from a strange woman that she chooses.
And yeah, she would reluctantly accept me going out and staying away from them. Of course, she wouldn't be happy about it, but that's more acceptable than a third person coming and staying here.
Yeah, but you talk about these things.
Yeah, we have talked about it.
क्योंकि मैं हमेशा इसको मना करती हूँ कि इसको लेके नहीं आओ.
But as is often the case in India, the law is out of date with the new gradual social acceptance. There's been much reporting about Section 377, which criminalizes homosexuality. Arvind Narayan is a writer and legal activist from Bangalore. He says that with an increasing number of gay men coming out, it makes it easy to question outdated laws that paint homosexuality as an aberration.
Well, I'll give you a quick example on the 377 petition and the case which happened. A film called Many People, Many Desires, made by the Bangalore-based group called Sangama, which talks about judges in the Delhi High Court. When the Indian government made the position that homosexuality is not a part of our culture, judges said, counsel, what are you referring to? Haven't we heard a protest in Calcutta, gay pride protest in Calcutta, where Indian men and women are claiming that they're gay and lesbian? How do you respond to that? Is the question the judges asked. So obviously this seems to indicate that coming out has an impact in terms of even changing judicial attitudes or the way judges see the entire phenomenon of homosexuality.
But that will take time. Until then, it's a constant search for private spaces and more cyberspace.
When you chat on the net, and then you become a pro at surfing profiles and knowing what people are doing.
This young 21-year-old has come out to his parents. They are struggling to cope with his homosexuality, but he exudes a confidence in his identity, one he says is fostered largely on the computer.
At 16, I discovered the internet, and when you're born in a country like India, which has no real exposure, or which did not have any real exposure towards the homosexual being, most of us in the beginning are very closeted. We're in the closet, and we have a very strong shield around us that we defend nail and tooth, just to be very sure that, you know, we want to live at the end of the day.
So this is a site called gaybombay.org, which is an Indian site. It's always, information is always very helpful, and you do find a lot of information. Like here, there are support channels. There's an HIV testing, there's issues. So it just depends on what you're looking for.
Gay Bombay was set up about 7 years back because a lot of gay men in the city felt the need to have an organization that would create social space, safe spaces for gay men.
Vikram is the man behind Gay Bombay. He set it up 7 years ago, but Vikram is still uncomfortable with being identified.
Gay Bombay is very focused on people who are coming into the community for the first time, you know, who are really nervous, who are scared, who have never met other gay men. We have fortnightly meetings at the houses of Gay Bombay members. We have parties in nightclubs which are willing to have parties. A lot of clubs are really cool. Of course, it's money for them. You know, they know that it's going to be a safe party, that we don't allow drugs, we don't allow sex. We're very strict about it. And a very safe party. You know, a lot of women, straight women, like coming for gay parties because, you know, it's an environment where they're safe, where nobody's going to be, like, you know, feeling them up, hitting on them, where they can dance to, like, really good music.
Gay Bombay group, of course, started as a mailing list.
Yeah. The internet has really revolutionized the gay community in India. It's been like a gateway. Suddenly they find like this whole, you know, gay world, this gay universe out there. Internet can cause problems as much as it can bring benefits. I mean, one of the biggest problems that the internet has caused has been it's helped the whole blackmailing. The rings that operate in Bombay really step up their operations to a new level and using the internet to entrap gay men. We have many cases on record of guys who have been caught by this blackmail ring and nobody has filed an FIR because they say that, you know, they say that it's still illegal to be gay in India. And how do we know that the police won't start prosecuting us? And how we don't.
Gay Bombay's events are always packed. It's just that we cannot film them directly because safety and anonymity is crucial. So that's the safety check we kept in mind when we filmed one such event, kite flying on Juhu Beach, an annual Makar Sankranti ritual. Thank you.